Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, my name is Meg. If you've been here for a while, thank you for continuing to support me. Today I wanted to talk about my transition towards slow fashion and secondhand fashion and why I decided to do that. So as many of you will know, for those of you who have been subscribed to me for a couple of years now, somewhere around 3 years ago, I decided to be a little bit more of a conscious consumerist. After having watched Kimberly Clark talk about conscious consumerism and the anti-hauls. So it started out with heavily reducing my consumption of makeup. I started off with unfollowing some beauty gurus that always seem to be showing off hauls that, to be honest, I don't need any more makeup. I'm still going through a shitload of makeup that I have had for years, okay? And so now I only buy like not even backups, like when I run out of something or when I know that I've only got a few uses left in a certain product, that's the only time that I would buy it. And I always try to do that when it's on sale, okay? Because I've got a few like backups. The thing is, because I've had so many backups of products that I use, they expire before I even get to use them because I've had them for like years. I've got eyeshadow palettes that have been with me for a while. I've started decluttering those, like selling them off on the Facebook Marketplace. Only the powder products. Liquids, I would never do that. Or giving them away to family and friends because, to be honest, I only have two lids. And recently, I haven't even been wanting to put on makeup. Like, honestly, when I go to work, I just have SPF on. This is probably the first time in a while that I've actually had a little bit of foundation on, and I've used a cushion foundation for this. So yeah, I've been really very minimal with my makeup. I've gone back to the more natural look as opposed to the cake it on my face, give me seven layers of foundation. I don't do that anymore. And yeah, even my eyeshadows, like, very minimal, sometimes just a single color on my lid, sometimes not even. And for the first time in a long time, I'm actually wearing false lashes today just because it'll look good on camera. But that's the only time I ever wear false lashes nowadays. I apologize if you're hearing some noise. I've got both my windows open for some air because I know, yeah, it's the middle of winter, but still. Anyway. So I started with, I keep digressing, I'm sorry, I go off on tangents. So I started off with minimizing my purchase of makeup. And to be honest, part of the reason why I did that was because at that time when I started being a conscious consumer, I didn't have a job. I was working from home, not working from home even. I was a stay-at-home partner. My partner, who is now my husband, is the one who's working. We were based in Vietnam. I didn't have an income of my own with the exception of whatever I make here in YouTube, which in some cases, nothing. There would be a month where I would have $100 maybe, and then several months without anything. And then I spend that little money that I have on makeup. And I had a credit card that I was using, but there was no money coming in to pay off that credit card. And to be honest, I just found myself in really bad financial situation. So I thought, I need to, you know, stop. And then, so I did that, and I did stop accumulating makeup. The other reason for me doing that was because I knew I was gonna come back to Australia, and filling up a luggage with just makeup and skincare was not a very practical thing to do, especially since I had clothes to haul with me back to Australia. And I was already filling in boxes for like other stuff that we owned that we wanted to bring in here because we knew that we were going to be permanently here after Vietnam. So I had to really drastically reduce what I owned, give away quite a few items of clothing and makeup and stuff because of the move back here in Australia. So that's how I ended up with that. And then I found myself having returned to Australia and making a relatively good income on my steady job. and found myself that while I didn't hoard makeup anymore, I was now more focused on fashion. If you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen me doing quite a few OOTDs, and in those cases, a lot of the times I don't use the same outfit or the same article of clothing. So I have once again gone into that addiction of shopping, even though I didn't need anything, and sometimes I didn't even want it, but I would see something on Instagram or on social media, I would see something on Facebook, I would watch a video on YouTube and find out, oh, okay, I kind of want to copy that look. But then I realized, wait a minute, you know, when else am I gonna wear that article of clothing? I have some clothes that I have donated that still had tags on them because they've never been worn, that I thought would look nice. And I have this habit, this really, really bad habit of buying stuff without trying them on to see if it looked good on me, because I used to live quite close to where the shopping mall was, and I always thought, oh, I can always return if it didn't fit me or if it didn't look good on me. And then I would forget about it, it would go at the back of my closet and it'd never get worn. So yeah, that I realized that very recently actually, and I was like, wait a minute, I got so into buying fashion and fast fashion at that, and then I see this video of all the garbage floating in the ocean, and I started looking at like, what's my contribution to that garbage problem? Single-use plastic. So I stopped using single-use plastic, and as much as I can, only ever use reusable items. Okay. And then what I learned with all of that was that the fashion industry is actually one of the biggest pollutants. Not just with the discarded clothing that people buy like, and wear once and then toss, right? It's not just even that particular end product garbage. It's the pollution that happens in the process of making that garment. Like when you buy your jeans, distressed jeans, do you know how many times that pair of jeans has to go through chemicals and where that chemicals end up? Yeah, it ends up in the water. I've even stopped using fabric softener in our clothes because I realized that that goes directly into the water system. After I've used it, like detergent is already bad enough, the fabric softener is even worse. And there, because those things don't have to label what are the toxic things that are in that particular product. And it's not even good for your clothes in the long run. It just makes your clothes feel soft for now, but in the long run, it's not actually going to be good for you, especially when you have a lot of active wear that you wash. Don't wash them with fabric softener. Anyway, so I realized all of this waste and pollutants that go into the environment. And I am by no means an environmentalist. I am very far from being a good, conscious, like environment conscious person. But I try in my little way to do what I can. And then I saw someone post, I don't even remember who it was, I saw someone post that whatever it is that you want or need in your closet has already been made. It's already out there, right? I mean, what article of clothing has not been invented yet? And all of these marketing about how you need that belt bag that's like all the rage right now, or those man sandals or mandals or whatever you call them, they're out there already. They've been made before. These are trends that are coming back from the 90s, from the 80s and all that stuff. So why not go vintage shopping, thrift shopping? Like, honestly, lately that's all I've ever been doing. When I feel the urge to buy and to go shopping, I don't go to the malls anymore because I don't want to buy anything brand new, because that means I'm just adding onto it. And the more you buy, the more you say to these companies, these fast fashion companies, that you want more, and they will continue to produce more because the demand is there. Okay, they will continue to supply it because people are still buying. So what my favorite place is now is an op shop. We call it op shop here. It's a thrift shop or a secondhand shop. is an op shop that's like a block away from my house, and it's Mustard Seed here in Sydney. Now, where I live is a little bit of a posh area, if I'm being honest. So the secondhand stuff that they sell there, I mean, I got a Karl Lagerfeld dress for $20. Can you imagine that? So yeah, there's a lot of gems that you can find there. Like this jacket, this blazer that I'm wearing right now is from the op shop. Yeah, and Vinny's, and which is St. Vincent de Paul, and that's a charity shop. And Salvo's or Salvation Army are now my favorite places to go to. It used to be Uniqlo, H&M and Zara and whatever. But if you look at one, the labor practices of those companies, like how much do they actually pay their laborers for the clothing that they make? Is it a livable wage, right? Second of all, do they participate in child labor? Next is, do they actually even pay their, because I heard that Uniqlo had some factories that have been unpaid for a while, right? So not even those ethical things, right, that we haven't really thought about because we just want to buy. But remember that your buying power, the money that you put into these companies, tells them that, oh, I can make more of these things. And what's been happening is because we keep having that demand, they keep trying to make the factories and the workers work more so they can produce more and more efficiently in less time. So the quality isn't always there. And what do they do with clothing that doesn't pass through their quality control? Where do you think that ends up? Okay. Next, because they are doing that or making that demand, factories are then now pushing their workers to work more hours or to do double shifts. Sometimes I know this, that in some places in the Philippines, some factories that produce for certain brands, I'm not 100% sure where the brands are, there have been accusations of them drugging, okay, their staff so that they are able to keep awake 24 hours so that they can keep producing. And how much do these people get paid? Okay. This is abuse. Okay. This is like slavery. And we don't want to go back to those times. So like just thinking about all of the factors that go in there, I realized, you know what? I'm just going to buy what I need. And every time now I go to the shops, even to the op shops, when I see something and I'm like, do I need it? How often am I going to wear this? How much wear am I going to get out of this? So seriously, like, is it worth purchasing? Do I really need this in my closet? So I guess that's some of the reasons why I decided that, look, I'm going to go into slow fashion. Because to be honest with you, I feel like clothes from the past have been made better. Okay. But recently with this surge of capitalism and this fear of missing out, and however you want to call it, like people always want to be, especially with the advent of social media where people are all about getting the likes and getting the, you know, getting the sponsorships, getting the marketing, and all the advent of these influencers, I guess myself included, although I'm not really that big of an influencer, has made people go buy. Like all of these Coachella or whatever festival it is that you need to have a certain type of clothing. Back in my day, you go to a concert and you wear whatever it is that's in your closet. Doesn't matter. Like you don't buy multiple outfits just to show off and to look like you're at a fancy concert, like a Woodstock, whatever. Like whatever happened to just being you and wearing what you have? So yeah, when I think about all of that, I realize that, you know, I really should be limiting my purchasing. I really should not be buying all these things because honestly, I don't need it. I don't have a need for it. I may want it, but would I want it later? So, yeah. And then I saw this video by Style Apotheca. I'm gonna link her channel down below where she talks about her low buy and why she has ended up going into a low buy, and it really resonated with me because, like her, I have been in a position where I was financially stressed out because I buy stuff I don't need. I buy multiples of things that I don't need just to be in the in crowd, just to be able to say that I have what everybody else does. And then I look at my closet filled with clothes that has been worn once, maybe sometimes never. And it just, I just really think that, you know what? No, I would pay off my credit cards and only use them again for things that I actually need. And yeah, and I like seeing my bank account going up instead of going down. I used to have this thing, well, I don't know what how you would classify this, but when I see that there's money in the bank account, I feel like I have to use it up. Like it has to be zero there. I am almost 40 and I have no savings to speak of because this is what I've been doing. So I realized, you know what? This needs to stop. I need to control myself. I have always been an impulsive buyer, and now, well, I look at something and I ask myself, do I need this? And if I am unsure of my answer, and if my answer is not an immediate yes, or if it's not even in my list of things that I actually need to buy, I walk away. And if I have forgotten about it after 3 days, then I don't go back for it. Because if it was something that I really needed, then it would be on my list of things that I need to buy, right? If it was something that I really wanted, I wouldn't forget about it within just 3 days. I would probably go back for it and buy it because I really want it, you know? So like, I ask the simple things to myself. I don't even ask myself, do I have the budget for this? I don't even go that far. I just go with, do I really need this? And if the answer is not an immediate yes, then I'm not gonna buy it, you know? So yeah, and I'm talking about this because I really want you guys to maybe think about what you purchase as well. How often you purchase and how often do you actually wear or use those things that you buy. Because maybe we're buying too much of things that we don't need and spending money that we don't have to impress people we don't even like. Yeah, I've seen that somewhere. So yeah, maybe think about that. Like, why are you even buying these things? Is it really because it's for you? Or is it to show off? Because really, how often are you gonna wear that if it's just for showing off? A lot of people buy outfits to use once and then discard. Okay? Those are just some of my thoughts. I hope you learned something from this video. It made you think and rethink and rethink. And if it did, I think it has served. I have served my purpose for this video. If you have any questions down below, leave them in the comment section down below. If you are in the same boat or struggling in the same way that I am with curbing your shopping addiction, let's do this together, okay? And yeah, thank you very much for joining me, and I'm sorry that this has been quite a long video. I can see it's like 18 minutes now. But yeah, thank you very much for sitting down with me and let me know about your thoughts on this video. Thank you. Bye.